I would say that, you know, getting good at these experiments is in many ways, you know, like getting good at a sport. You don't think about what you need to do, you just know what you need to do at any moment. The goal of trying to record from 12 neurons at a time is a very ambitious goal. But what we're trying to do along the way is figure out, well, what is reasonable? How many is reasonable? How good can we make the process of recording from multiple neurons? To get these recordings, you know, you need to physically place a glass pipette, the tip of a glass pipette, onto a neuron. You know, that's with submicron precision. And typically that's done with these devices called micromanipulators. I guess you could divide a rig up into maybe three or four major components. You know, there's your optical tools that allow you to see the cell. There are your manipulators, your physical tools that allow you to place those electrodes onto the cells. And then there's also, you know, sort of all your digitizing and amplifying tools that allow you to record and process the signals from those neurons. And then finally, there are the life support tools that keep that tissue that you're recording from sort of artificially alive. It's important to try this multi-patching because, you know, this is just simple math. Like, if I can get 10 recordings at a time, that's equivalent to a month's work by a person doing two recordings at a time. So if it does work, you know, it would take an army of people to keep up with it.